Yeah, what are some of the hacks? Like, you're out door knocking, you're out listening, you're running a business, whatever it is, and you're not happy. What is the, how do I become happy?
So I think the first is reframing your mindset that a person, place, or thing won't make you happy. Because the way 99% of people live their life is, I have a version of how I think the world should be, and so I'm going to go out into the marketplace or the world and manipulate and try and convince things to be the way I think they're supposed to be. Mm. But the way you believe the world should be is very different than the way I think so. And the different than every single person listening and different than every perspective on planet Earth. So what's really going on is we're on like this arena called Earth, and there's 7.7 billion people who all think the world should be a specific way. And so they go out and try and force their beliefs onto other and force their opinions and try and manipulate and force their way. So that if everything can line up perfectly, then I can be okay. Right. And so often than not, we're trying to solve this problem. Right. So especially I love working in the door-to-door space because it's a lot of self-motivated people, self-starters who are motivated and who are hungry, who want to make a change in their life. Right. But the biggest missing piece is they think they're trying to solve this problem, and it gets really, really exhausting. And you get exhausted of like, if only I can be the top rep, if only I can get my business bigger, if only then things will be okay. Right. Then it's, you're almost like working to a completion, but that completion never comes. I call this happy when syndrome. Most people live in happy when syndrome, right? Just, I'm so close. As soon as I get a better body, then I can get a girlfriend. Or as soon as I make a little bit more and get out of debt and the top rep, then things will be happy. But really, there's that your ship never comes in. That never happens, right?
In awareness, it talks about the happiness is already in you.
Yeah. Like, but it's blocked.
It's blocked. It's like nobody can, yeah, like you said, no person, place, or thing can make you happy. It's just the happiness is in you.
Yeah.
It's just a matter of are you accessing it?
Yeah.
Or is it covered up by all of the judgment, like your perception or your way of this is how it needs to look, and I don't look that way, therefore I'm not enough.
Right.
Therefore I'm not, like you said, when I have.
Yeah.
And you know, it's so funny, people are like, if I just had $1 million, if I just had $100,000, if I just had no debt, like oh, it's like you'll get $1 million. Or like, guys, I'm the perfect example. Like, to open up, like, I had the Labradoodle, the dream home, the wife, the three kids, the wife had a boutique, to the my whole, on paper, every like millionaire, like, drove the car I want, traveled the world. I have a very similar story to Doug, and that's why we're such homies. Is I had the balls to be like, I'm not happy though, and I chased the wrong thing. And over the last year, I've gone through a similar journey like Doug, and it's like, oh, I just need to find the happiness in me and stop chasing things.
Yeah, and I think our natural state as humans on this earth is our natural state is love and happiness, but they're blocked, right? You know, we have traumatic experiences when we were a kid, or, you know, really the reason you're unhappy is because life isn't unfolding the way you think it was supposed to.
Mm.
Bottom line. Right. But life is under no obligation to be any way at all. You're an experiencer of life. And so when you attach to an idea that life needs to look like this, or when you resist something you don't want to have happen, right, you are allowing those unfolding events to shape your personal happiness. Right. And so the key here in all this, the really deep rooted truth, is surrender. Right. Letting life happen. Right, allowing life to unfold the way it is without being attached to a specific way. Right, that doesn't mean surrender. Doesn't mean quit your job and move to a cave. Right, it means showing up as your very best self. Right, in integrity with who you are as a human, putting out your best effort, but allowing the life to go a different way and allowing things to change. Because think about where you are right now in your life with your business and your personal life with your relationships. If I were to sit down and we were like, all right, Sam, 3 years ago today, let's plan out the next 3 years of your life.
Definitely would not be in this situation.
Yeah. Not being married anymore, having a podcast with me, having this conversation wouldn't be on the list. I don't care how much time we spend together.
Yeah, last podcast, right. We're at my house.
Yeah.
I don't have that house anymore.
Yeah, right.
It's like,
so life is going to unfold, right? And you have no control over it, right? You don't have control over people, places, or things. The only thing you have control over is your personal effort and your personal internal state.
And almost like your response to those
things. in your response to those, 100%, right? And so how do we get an alignment, really? Because and the first thing to answer your question going backwards is understanding, especially in our industry, that material items won't make you happy. And I know that's very cliche, but what I mean by that is you're not seeking money. You don't want money. You want the experience you think money will bring, right? You think it'll make you feel excited and enthusiastic and motivated and full of joy and full of love. That's what we're all seeking. If you think of anything you want in your life, what you're really seeking is the emotion tied behind it, right? If I said, all right, Sam, I'll give you a check for $1 billion cash right now, yours, but you're going to feel extreme overwhelm, anxiety, and depression all the time.
Yeah, I wouldn't take it.
You don't want it, right? You want the mental state you think these things will bring. You want to feel calm. You want to feel confident. You want to feel motivated. You want to feel love. You want to feel enthusiasm. So we're a very emotional beings, right? And so once you understand that, then you can actually start hacking your life in different ways, realizing, you know what? I actually don't want the Ferrari. What I want is I want the feeling of feeling like I'm respected, right? And that I'm loved and that I'm valued in the world.
Yeah.
And you can get that without the Ferrari.
Love that.
Yeah.